Next, may we have Myanmar, Your Excellency, please.
Thank you. Excellency, Mr. Chair and Vice Chair, ministers from ASEAN member states, Secretary General of ASEAN, representatives from ASEAN Committee on Disaster Management, Executive Director of AHA Center, ladies and gentlemen, very good morning and Minglaba. First of all, I would like to wish everybody participating in today's meeting for well-being amidst the challenges posed by the COVID-19 pandemic. My congratulations to Mr. Chairman for your dedicated leadership during Singapore's chairmanship and for successfully hosting both AMMDM and ACDM adapting the new normal situation under COVID-19. And I would like to appreciate ACDM working groups for initiating necessary measures to implement new priorities under the ADMA Work Program 2021-2025. I believe that active engagement, contribution, and implementation by ASEAN member states will ensure successful outcomes for our regional disaster risk reduction. Moreover, the ongoing new initiatives like web-based monitoring and evaluation system and ASEAN Disaster Resilience Outlook reflect our willingness to apply technology in the regional disaster management system. ASEAN Secretariat is very noteworthy for its strong coordination and support for such innovation. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, ASEAN experiences various natural disasters across the region on every year basis, and ASEAN member states have been trying to become resilient at national level. According to the Global Climate Risk Index 2020, the four ASEAN member states, Myanmar, Philippines, Thailand, and Vietnam, are categorized in the top 10 countries in the world that suffered the most from extreme weather for the last two decades. Moreover, it is the fact that the loss and damage due to climate-related disasters negatively affect the socioeconomic development of the people. In the meantime, the spread of COVID-19 and its consequences compounded the situation and threaten regional economies. To overcome such challenges together, one ASEAN, one response separate is crucial, and strengthening partnership among member states becomes more significant. Without a strong partnership and cross-sector collaboration, our overall resilience and recovery may have been limited. As such, with emerging and unforeseen challenges ahead, the implementation of the ADMA Work Program must be enhanced through innovation and synchronized coordination amongst relevant actors in the region and beyond. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, our country, Myanmar, is vulnerable to both hydrological and meteorological disasters according to its geographical setting. Moreover, rapid onset disasters such as earthquake and flash flood are likely to hit Myanmar frequently. Based on the country's experience, we prioritize climate change adaptation and disaster management to reduce preventable losses at the national level. National Disaster Management Committee, led by Deputy Prime Minister, is enforcing an all-inclusive disaster management system. Under this national committee, 12 working committees are formed as per emergency support functions, along with civil military coordination to undertake interventions across the disaster management cycle. We are inspiring to have disaster resilient society through cooperation, coordination, and collaboration among relevant stakeholders like government, civil society, community volunteers, private sector, and academia. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, In fighting against COVID-19, Myanmar is trying to increase the vaccine coverage with no one left behind approach, and thus making sure that ethnic armed organizations and IDP camps are included in vaccine programs with the aim of bringing down transmission and mortality rates and easing resultant negative impact on the business sector. Here, I would like to express my profound thanks, not only to ASEAN leaders, but also to relevant ministers of AMMDM for your strong commitment and assistance to combat COVID-19 in Myanmar through the ASEAN Humanitarian Assistance Project. These medical supplies have been distributed to needed areas through Myanmar Red Cross Society. Government of Myanmar also organizes the task force that combines relevant ministries to coordinate with ASEAN Secretariat and AHA Center for smooth implementation on point four of the 5-point consensus adopted at ASEAN leaders meeting on 24th April 2021. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, in summary, I am confident that our strong participation and collective action will further reinforce the proactive approach against the negative impact of various shocks across the region. That is why I urge all ASEAN member states to maintain this as our shared invaluable asset and have greater collaboration ahead. Let me conclude by saying thanks to all the AMMDM ministers for your participation and cooperation, and congratulations once again to ACDM, ASEAN Secretariat, and AHA Center for spearheading the journey of disaster risk reduction. As for Myanmar, we stand ready to cooperate with our ASEAN family members and will further extend our disaster risk reduction measures under Thailand's chairmanship of AMMDM in 2022. I do wish our AMMDM and ACDM to keep the momentum to strive for the achievement of ASEAN's vision to become a global leader in disaster management. Thank you very much for your attention. May you all be safe and healthy.